Thank you very much. Just, ladies and gentlemen, just small information. It's my first visit to UK, but also I insisted to speak with you in English. I refused to speak with you in French because my English is very new. I started to speak English since 1 year, 6 months in this crisis. Of course, I address my great thanks for this opportunity to meet UK people in London. I like it through this day. I am here for 1 day because I have a lot of the meeting in Paris also and Rome. For World Minimum Fund for this invitation, especially Dr. John Darlington and Lisa Ackerman's vice president, and also Buddy Burham. Because not just for the invitation, but also for the position of the World Minimum Fund. In summer 2012, they told me you should to present action plan, how we can save Syrian cultural heritage through this crisis. The situation was very difficult. I already had another experience when I have about 35 old. I look at the experience in National Museum in Baghdad, what happened in 2003. How we can to save Syrian collections in museums and do not repeat what happened in Baghdad Museum in Damascus and all Syria. Of course, the job is very difficult. I declare it a lot of the time I am the saddest director general in the world because each day I receive the bad news about the destruction of my cultural heritage in Syria. How I can, with my colleague, 2,500 persons, still now working with me in both sides, in the side under control of the opposition and also government, but we refuse it to have separation for the cultural heritage. We have 10,000 sites, we have 34 museums, more 300,000 objects. What we can do? Lift Syria, try to have with children the quiet life, and do not do anything to preserve all these collections, to give the mafia for the looting, for the destruction, we refuse it. We decided to stay in Damascus with all my colleagues. I am proud because I am with these colleagues, my ancient students from Damascus University. I am very happy. More 300 former students, now they are my colleagues in this cultural battle. Because it is cultural battle, it's not politic. I understand for the politic. Of course, in politics we have opposition, we have the government, but for the cultural heritage we cannot accept this. We have one heritage for one people. It is common heritage, it's common memory, it's common identity. It is not just for Syrian people also. It's our common heritage, because our cultural heritage, it is humanity heritage. Of course, we have also the common responsibility. We passed a lot of the time in isolation. Really, I was very sad. Why? A lot of the partners left us. Why? Because we are public? Of course, we are public. We haven't in the world, Directorate General of the Antiquity and Museum provide. We have 2,500 persons. We are working. And it's for this, I am proud for the cooperation with World Minimum Fund, UNESCO, do it excellent work with me, ECOMOS, ECROM, Interpol, a lot of institutes in the world, hundreds, biggest scientific archaeologists keep in touch with me, Maamoun, we are with you. You should to stay in Syria, Damascus. We are with you. The war was very difficult. The crisis became very violent. And what happened? We have new tragedy, because what we have in Syria, we hadn't in experience of Baghdad, we hadn't in this time ISIS group. How we can make something for these people? I can give you, I want to make you, to present you the tragedy of the ruins. Just I give you some small idea about the beauty of the ruins. About this beauty of the ruins, we decided to stay in Syria with our family, our children. We refused to leave Damascus. So this work, 3 years ago, we closed the museums, we evacuated all the collections, we transported all the collections, we preserved about 99% of the collection in the museum, about 300,000 objects now, still now, are in safe places. It is good. It is. This work, it is not for me personal. It is not because I am already the saddest person, but it's for the Syrian people, for all Syrian, for UK people, European people, international community, because we presented new model through all the tragedy. A lot of the question we had, why you keep in touch in cultural heritage, but we have a lot of the refugee, we have a lot of the humanitarian bad situation. It's of course, we are from these people. We have all this kind of the problems. We haven't electricity. My as director general, a lot of the time we haven't electricity in my houses. With like any person in Syria, I don't know how, where we will kill it. Before Khaled Assad in Le Point, in my interview in Le Point, in last July, I told, I don't know how we will condemn it and kill it by this terrorist. Khaled Assad, it was example, what happened with him. After Khaled Assad, in last month also, we lost another colleague, they beheaded another guard. The battle is cultural, how we can keep the hope in the heart. If we lost the hope, we will lose the control of this cultural heritage. Our vision, what do you know? We refuse it to use our cultural heritage for the political agenda. We appeal it all the parties respect our cultural heritage. Do not use the cultural heritage as a battlefield. And we protected it is National Museum of Aleppo. It is example of some measure we talk in this museum, but I give you confirmation that we finish it in this year. The transporting of 24,000 objects from this museum to safe places in Damascus. But if we look this picture, we have double sentiment. One, I am sad. How many groups, tourists, scientific, enter through this gate? Now it's closed because it's war. Why our museums today all close it? But in another side, for the hope, we are happy because we saved the collections for our children's, for the futures. It's for this, what happened, it was good. Sometimes the government, not here. You know what happened in Syria through the media, etc. What we can do to save the cultural heritage sites, not museums. We keep it touch with local community. So this cooperation, excellent cooperation, we saved 1,000 sites. We appealed the elite, tribal, cultural, religion. It's your honor of the mazar. It's not politic. It's your job to save this cultural heritage for your children. We launched a lot of the, like these pictures, a lot, thousand pictures, media, etc. in 2012. We pushed the Syrian people to be with us in this battle because And finally, our work is scientific. It was good things, and we tried to also to keep the good relation with cultural organizations like World Monument Fund, UNESCO, and to exchange the idea, what happened, etc. But if we can discuss with you, not very in details, because my English cannot throw my English enter in details for the time also, we have three kind of the problem. For the Syrian cultural side, because the museum, we finished it. It was good. It was beauty. Now we are in tragedy. When it clashes, a lot of the sites destroy it, like the example of Aleppo. It is like one city of the Second War, like Varsovia. 150 individual building damaged. 1,000 market in ancient market damaged by fire. Hundreds how traditional houses damaged in Aleppo. Of course, sometimes it's heavy, middle, little, but in general, Aleppo is one of the significant of destruction. It was one of the most beautiful city from the Islamic world. Aleppo, it was example for the tourism. We are sad because I asked my staff cannot enter in this area. I appealed special mission to go in the middle city in April, last April. It's image of the April before and after. How many destruction? Look this, it's ancient mosque, Umayyad, from 8th century, 12th century. What happened in this mosque? It's a citadel. How many tourists were here to talk, some drink, something like we are in front of some disaster. It is, we are in the war, like. It's ancient mark of Aleppo, more 1,000 mark damaged by fire. 150 building damaged by through this crisis, like this building mosque. And also another city, Homs city. But now this image, it was in 2014, but through 1 year we restored this church, now it's good. And we already started to restore a lot of the building in Homs city in the center of the Syria, because we try to do our job the best. Why? Because if this building stay like this in this situation for the winters, after winters, we will have a lot of damage. It's for this, it was necessary to have the intervention with the municipality, with all the partner in Syria, syndicate, etc. We restore it and church and mosque, etc. We restore it a lot of the restore it through our Ministry of the Culture, because our budget coming from the Ministry of the Cultural, and we pay it until now the salary for 2,500 persons in all the Syria. It is Crac de Chevalier, it's very famous in the world. Fortunately, the damage is not very so heavy. We already finished phase one of the restoration. I was in Rome last week. We will start in the beginning of the next year, 2016, phase two, because sometimes we need expertise. I have more 500 architects. Like this number also archaeologists, but we need also international community. How the international community can help us for the expertise. We cannot stay 2, 3, 4 years more and left Crac de Chevalier in this situation. We need to have very quick intervention and to restore something. So this, it is our common responsibility. It was this image of Crac de Chevalier, but it's now very clean, it's open. We asked it through Syrian minister, to ask the Syrian official army to recuperate this citadel. Now we are, my staff are working. We have any things. It's good situation. We try it now to open for the some, we haven't journalists, we haven't tourists in Syria now, but we have a lot of the journalists coming from all the countries, and we permit all the people to enter to visit this citadel. It is Christian town beside of Damascus, damaged by clashes, by fundamentalists, but this image, it is not, we have three images before, now clashes, and we restore it in 2015. We finish it. Now all the people can use this church, and its image of some houses in this town, and we already started by a lot of the restoration. Sometime we have another kind of the damage for the locals who lived their houses, lost their houses. Sometimes they use it, the ancient stone, for new construction. It was necessary for us to convince these people, you can live in the site, but do not use the fire and destruction, and also do not permit to mafia theft coming in these sites, but you can use. So our cooperation with local community, it was excellent model. We convinced the people in the north of the Syria to protect this site, because it is my field, my specialty. I am co-director of this 700 village from the Roman Byzantine period. Another kind of the problem, it is after the clashes. I remember in the beginning in 2013, I appealed international community, how you can help us, because we received a lot of the reports about the coming of the theft and the mafia in the Syria. Please do not lift us. You should to push the neighboring countries to control the borders. Unfortunately, I stayed in isolation. You can read my name and February 2013 by Reuters and Associated. I appealed international committee, please help us. In July, in same year, 2013, I declared new statement. I appealed international committee, how you can help us? How you can stop this mafia? How you can control the market black? How you can convince all these person do not accept the selling of the Syrian artifacts and Iraqi artifacts, because they are in the war. Unfortunately, a lot of the area became under the disaster, like this image. It's a lot of the very important sites. All these sites, what you know in the map of the Syria, it's damaged. A lot of the people through the day, of course, the theft existed in all the countries before crisis also. But sometime it was in the night, small groups. But what happened in Syria in 2013 and 14 and 15 now? We have a lot of the groups, they use bulldozer. They are about 200-300 person. In day and night, they make a lot of the destruction by all the facility. So especially under control of the terrorists of the ISIS. They push the people, the safe, to attack the city, because you know ISIS group tried to sell a lot of the anti-Syrian antiquity, petrol, etc., etc. It's a challenge now, how we can stop this phenomenon. And they attack it. This image, it was very sad image. The international community, you can compare between this image and this image, before, after. How many thousands dig we have now in this beautiful city dated 2003 century. And this image, we sent some mission in the field like this. How many thousands like this? The site damaged, attacked by the theft. They used bulldozer. Sometime it was necessary to make the quick digging, they use a bulldozer. It is a disaster situation. The people around of the site not very strong. If the people, local community, society, civil, very strong, like small city, small town, we appeal it directly. We saved 1,000 sites in northeast of the Syria. With this area, I visited last July, this area, we appeal the local community. They saved more 1,000 sites in south of the Syria, in the middle. But sometimes, if the situation like police, custom, etc., etc., not here, if the social society or local community not very strong, it is this situation what happened in Syria. It is the site of Ibla. It's one of the most important site in the Syria. We found in this site more 16,000 cuneiform tablet. And through the local community, excellent, because it's not under control of the opposition government, we appealed the local community. We reduce it 90% of the digging. We are really happy for this site. Now it's more better than another site. It's Palmyra. How they use it, this technique to enter in the tombs, ancient tomb from the Roman period, just to have this statue like this. A lot of destruction do it. This ceramic, all destroyed last year by ISIS group. I don't know until now why they destroyed this ceramic, because it's not ideologic. We have three problems with ISIS: ideology, vengeance, and also selling. If the object is very high prices, good, etc., it's for the selling. If they are, it's statue, etc., it's for ideological. Sometimes it's vengeance, just vengeance. Sometimes because they are ignorant people, they are sauvage. Some image of ideological, it's third kind of the problem in Syria since last year with ISIS group. They destroyed it more, I think, the totality of the Muslim mausoleum, because the ideology of the ISIS don't accept the tomb in elevation. They destroyed all things. They attacked all the mausoleum, they attacked church, monastery, and also the temple. Well, like it's tombs from the Roman period, digged and destroyed by ISIS. Palmyra, 3 days before captured Palmyra by ISIS. I asked the family of Khalid al-Assad, his son, because he is director of the antiquity here. I told him, Walid, please send me the new image of Palmyra. What is the situation? Because in our mind, I was sure that Palmyra will be as Palmyra. But when we lost Palmyra, it was shock for us. Until now, we are under the shock. It's Temple of the Bell, 43,000 meters square. And this connection between Orient and Occident as architecture and art. And it is icon of the caravan city through the history. It was beautiful in the heart of all the tourists from UK, person coming through 17th, 18th century, do it a lot of the good work about Palmyra. Now, what happened? It is our cella, the temple, the central building in this building. All person were proud to talk the picture with their family beside of this temple. We tried, we appealed all the person in the world. I crying, please, Palmyra, for me, the battle, it's Palmyra battle. It is international battle. All the international community should to be together for Palmyra. Syrian official army, Syrian opposition, coalition, Russia, Africa, Japan, etc., all the international community should do something to save this civilization. But unfortunately, the image from this site was more sad for me, for all the international community. What happened after? They destroyed this temple by this barbaric method. I keep it, I try it, because I have, until now, 45 colleagues living in Palmyra. I asked my colleague, please, try to convince this barbar that this temple, it's not temple. This temple became church, after church became mosque. You should to keep this temple because it's not the temple. You should do another. They refuse it. No. We don't know after 1 century, 2 centuries, perhaps the people will back to paganism. It's our responsibility to destroy it now. They do it, I think. The result, by image of satellite, we lost totality. In the field, like this situation. Now, I told you I will keep the hope. I will rebuild this temple in the future. Another temple, Baal Shamin, became church through the Byzantine period. It was very nice, small, not like Baal, but very jolly, very beautiful. Result, another kind of image. For me, the question, why we need this image just to move? We should to move before this image. We should to be together in this battle. If we decided to stay in this battle with our children, with all the risk, why you refuse to ask just because we are public? It's not a reason for me. A lot of this image happened in Syria, in Palmyra, like the results, what happened. Fortunately, we have all documentation and details from A to Z. We have all documentation. My hope now, if we do the assessment, how many stone broken? It's a challenge also with us. If we have anything, we will continue our job, what I told you, to rebuild. Palmyra was very famous by tombs from Roman period, funerary towers, very beautiful. Ilahbel from first century. It's connection also between Orient and Greco-Roman art. Inside, it's very beautiful temple, tower. They destroyed all this tower also. And second step, also they attack it, not for the ideological, for the vengeance, because they know how many Palmyra is very important in the heart of the people in the world. Sometimes we have a lot of discussion with journalists, with some people, they told me, why you declare all time, each week, each 2 weeks, you declare what happened in Palmyra? I told him, them, because I refuse the destruction of Palmyra will happen it in the silence. Each day, if I have destruction anti-Palmyra, I will declare through all the journalists in the world to move the world how we can save. Because if we accept, because I know this barbar, through my colleagues, through this mentality, how they think about the cultural element, because they refuse this. They condemn us not because we are. Some countries in the world refuse to contact us because we are public, but ISIS group refuse us not for just for the first reason. We have the second reason, because they condemned us, we protect the statue as idol. We are already condemned. Church from the end of the 2nd century destroyed the image of explosion. It's here, what you see here. But after this image, we have another image. They used bulldozer to destroy totality of this arch. They destroyed also the Lyon. This Lyon, it's 15 ton, destroyed also. They transformed our National Museum to court and prison. They destroyed a lot of the image of this mosaic because we have a representation. They destroyed a lot of the statue from the Assyrian period. It's dated 3000, this image coming from East, they destroyed already. And you know the history of Khalid al-Assad, the man who saved his life 60 years for the Palmyra. The man, scientific man, and gentleman. He was brave man, modest man, with big charisma. A lot of the beautiful things we can talk about Khalid al-Assad. When Palmyra up down in the hand of these groups, I appealed to Mr. Khalid al-Assad. I told him, for him and his son, new director since 10 years, he's very weak, very tired, his son, because he has some problem for his health. I told him, you should to leave Palmyra, please, because you will be condemned. You are already participated in the safeguarding of the Syrian collection from National Museum of Palmyra, because before, we already, like all the museum in Syria, we saved more 400 statues. We saved hundreds of the glasses, ceramic, etc. Now your work, it's finished. He told me, please, I am born here. I live it here more 82 years. It's forbidden for me to leave Palmyra in these conditions. For me, the life is finished. But I can never to give them, these terrorists, the legitimacy to be in Palmyra alone. For me, really, it's the first time I talk. For me, the problem wasn't Khalid al-Assad. I never thought that they will kill Khalid al-Assad because he's old man. For me, the challenge was the life of his son. But finally, you know what happened for Khalid al-Assad? It was the message of terror. Khalid al-Assad wasn't just a scientific man. He was an elite. He was a boss of Palmyra, senior of Palmyra. Daesh killed Khalid al-Assad by this method, barbaric method, just to give the people of Palmyra the message. Your elite killed by this method. Any person refuse our presence in Palmyra, we will kill him like Khalid al-Assad. It was a message of terror. Of course, they tried to discuss with Khalid al-Assad, with my colleagues, why you don't declare where you hide 2 tons of gold. They are ignorant people. They think that the Syrian government hide 2 tons gold from the Zenobia periods. They are really, they are barbar. When they found we have anything in their city, they went to another kind of the terror of to terrorize the people. For the museums, it was the tragedy of all the Syrian sites, but for all the museums, I give you the confirmation what I told in the beginning of my lectures, the totality in general of the collection still now in safe places. We documented by 50 archaeologists, young and IT, more 250,000 new pictures. We have good database now. We do it a lot of the work about the documentation because we have the times in Damascus when we receive all the objects like Deir ez-Zor, it is surrounded by ISIS groups. We decided to transport 30,000 objects by military flights to Damascus. Of course, all times we are protected by police because we cannot, as archaeologists, to move 30,000 objects alone because it's the memory of the people. The Syrian police helped us through this work. And It was good occasion for us to do new documentation from A to Z. It was very good. Very quickly, I can give you some picture. It's some museum, it's restored, it's now open, but we haven't objects in Homs in central of Syria. It is a museum of, it's the most beautiful museum of mosaic in Middle East. Now this city under control of the opposition, but through my staff, through the local community, through the elite, we neutralized this museum. We are sure that all the collection, all the museum in good and safety, because the local community helped us. It's Idlib. It is, we have Islamic groups now in Idlib, but also through the local community, all the elites, we presented new model, how you can help your cultural heritage in this city. It was the last image. Some objects, 1, 2, 3 objects, it was a question of the looting from some museums, but in general, what I told you, 300,000 objects in safe places. Like my colleague, about 50 person, they are already my ancient students. Now it's like this. We received a delegation from UNESCO and we showed UNESCO all our measures. Sometimes we have the bad experience in some countries in the history. They saved the objects from the clashes, but they lost by humidity, by fires. It's for this we try to have all kind of the measure, how we can to have this measure of the packing, and this gate, one of the gates, about 4 ton of metallic, and to have a lot of the gates, like the gate of the synagogue of Damascus, because in National Museum we have the more beautiful synagogue in the world, dated from 3rd century. We put a lot of this gate just to protect all things. It's our my staff, all time, try to restore, etc. We have a colleague from university coming here just for the visit, etc. But we do it a lot, good database, what we have now in Syria. It's the kind of the packing. It is how we prepared to sit for the safe places. We have thousands, I haven't the number, like these boxes. After we finish, we send to safe places for 1, 2, 3 years. But I hope to recuper all things and Syrian crisis will finish quickly. And we have our sites. We do it a lot of the inventory. We have a good relation in UK. Beside of World Monument Fund, we have also good relation with Stephen Simon, Professor Stephen Simon from Yale University and Durham University for inventory also. We do it a lot of the work with them. And now we are preparing some new project with Oxford about three dimension. And also we do it this site in two language, Arabic, English. We publish all things. Bad news, good news. We should to share our data with all the international community because it is our common heritage. And we insisted do not use any report for politic agenda. We should to be scientific, neutral to save our cultural heritage. It is our company. We launched a lot of the company like this through all the Syria, university, etc., to push the people with the small word, but very significant, to push the people how you can to save your heritage. It's excellent model of the work with local community. We found this mosaic. It's very ancient mosaic from the 5th century in Damascus area. It is in the conflict area. Through our colleagues who are living in this village and they are in our staff in National Museum, they played good role to mediation through the local community to convince the group's army to recuperate this mosaic. It was a successful operation. We recuperated this mosaic, we restored it, we presented it in the National Museum. And sometimes, after some time, they found in tombs, Roman tombs, about 200 like this, glasses and ceramic, they sent us to National Museum. Through this experience, we tried to talk all time with local community, with the people. It's your heritage, it's your responsibility. It is not just my responsibility and responsibility of my staff. And Busra city in the south of the sea, it's very beautiful. It's like Palmyra. When Busra captured by group's army, we contacted directly with local community. The local community, all the elite, played good role and to keep our staff in the work. Until now, my staff are working in Busra. They do it good work, and they saved all these statues in basalt, more 200 statues and mosaic here, a lot of the collection. They do a lot of the work of the cleaning in the citadel of, it's one of the most beautiful citadel in the Mediterranean. And what happened here also, they do it a lot of the, some small restoration and cleaning. And through all our work also, we measure with local, with ONG, and we recuperate through this crisis more 6,000 objects from Syrian police. Of course, 6,000, not all time like this. Sometimes falks, sometimes original, sometimes small. But in general, it was good work with student training, etc. And finally, I think what we need some concrete measure from international community through this resolution. How international community can help us? How they can control the market black? How they can push the neighboring countries to stop the movement of the mafia. And fortunately, we have this name of the organization, worked for many times, in general, of course, World Monument Fund, New York, Britain, and all these names, they are with us. We have with us in this battle, cultural battle, hundreds of archaeologists, biggest scientific from France, UK. We have a good colleague in British Museum, in Louvre, in Bergamon Museum. We are sure that we are not alone because we have a lot of the people with us. And I think I have one last thing through this meeting, through this people in UK, so this is my first visit to appeal international committee, how you can move, how you can help us before to be too late. Thank you very much.
I think the term hero is often overused, and heritage hero sounds a bit of a cliche, but actually I can't think of a more appropriate term for the professor and actually his team back in Syria. So thank you hugely for coming to speak with us. I might, perhaps on behalf of the audience, perhaps just ask a couple of questions before you go, and that is, in terms of how people here can help, What's the thing that people can do in this room which might help you?
I think all time I repeat, I feel with my colleague very cold in isolation. One, the international community and UK people should to stay with us and first of all, for the human relation, if we are in life or we are already killed, first of all, we need the contact of our colleagues, the contact, the scientific exchange. It's very important. We receive a good fund from Union, from European Union through the UNESCO for the formation. After 5 years, I think my colleagues, young archaeologists, who saved this cultural heritage, need also some to show them what happened in the world, how you can preserve from anti-humidity, etc. They need some scientific measure, new technology, etc. I think it's not good. We are condemned all time to be in this isolation. Through this work we have also how we can together to follow all the market black, how we can condemn all the people in the world who accept to buy our collections. They should to understand if you buy Syrian, Iraqi collection, you support ISIS group by your acts.
And a final question, actually, and that is, it's an incredibly chaotic, tragic place at the moment, but can you see light at the end of the tunnel?
Yeah, it's best questions. Through my English, I cannot, because very important questions, but I will try to be more clear. I think if we lose the hope in our heart, we will lose the control on the cultural heritage Syria. I am sure how we will save it, 99% of the Syrian collections, I am sure we will have the big light in the in this tunnel what you talk.
Thank you.
Excuse me.